It's not unusual to experience difficulty starting the car in the morning, especially if the battery is dead and the weather is chilly. This reasoning suggests that restarting a warm engine shouldn't be challenging. Yes, in most cases, but hard start when engine is hot could cause more serious issues. In this brief video, we look at every scenario in which your car might have trouble starting when it's hot, or not start at all. It's the Car Problems YouTube channel. Subscribe and let's get started. Clogged air filter. One component that is replaced as part of routine maintenance is the air filter. However, a lot of people wait until the filter is clogged and full of debris before replacing it. When the air filter is functioning properly, it prevents contaminants, dust, and other particles from entering the motor. However, as these particles accumulate in the filter, a blockage will eventually result. You will notice decreased engine performance, which will lead to decreased acceleration, misfiring, and poor fuel economy when the proper amount of air cannot enter the combustion chamber. Defective crankshaft or camshaft position sensor. When the engine heats up, the symptoms of a failing crankshaft or camshaft position sensor may become more apparent. Both of these sensors are in charge of keeping track of each part's rotation and relay that data to the ECU. This data is used by the ECU to control how the spark plugs fire. Intermittent problems are possible if there is a problem or a misunderstanding, especially when the engine is warm. When that happens, the internal circuitry enlarges and causes more issues. Once it has cooled off, the engine might function normally once more. You might notice additional signs if the position sensor isn't working properly. This can occasionally result in a blinking check engine light, exhaust backfires, and excessive vibrations. Vapor lock. A vapor lock results if the fuel vaporizes before entering the combustion chamber. This happens when the fuel enters the fuel injection system and begins to boil. The flow to the engine is reduced during this period as the vapor and liquid mix. The likelihood of this condition tends to increase in hot weather. Additionally, the proximity of the fuel lines to the hot engine increases the likelihood of a vapor lock. In addition to having trouble starting the engine when a vapor lock happens, you'll also notice a lack of power and possibly some stalling issues. Try placing a bag of ice on the fuel lines for a few minutes if your car won't start due to a vapor lock. Bad engine ground connection. For the engine to function as it should, the ground connection is necessary. Circuit resistance may increase if the connection corrodes or becomes loose. This will have an impact on the starting system, as well as other components. Either the electrical components are acting strangely, or the transmission may be acting up. You must use a multimeter to conduct a voltage drop test on the engine grounds in order to correct the issue. Faulty battery connection. The battery may wiggle in its holder as the car shakes. The battery connections may become loose with time. Corrosion can also happen, further weakening the connection. The issues caused by this disconnect can occasionally be worse when the engine is hot. You might experience difficulty starting the motor as well as problems with the electrical accessories. Defective starter. The starter has a motor inside that can degrade over time. When the engine heats up, a failing starter may completely stop functioning. To send current to the windings, the starter motor contains a slip ring commutator and carbon brushes. The motor will have more resistance as the parts deteriorate, which is a problem when the electrical resistance rises. You might hear a buzzing sound coming from the motor as it breaks down, a loud clicking sound when you try to start the engine, or a grinding sound. You should be able to determine whether the starter is malfunctioning with a voltage drop test. Fuel system issues. There may be a number of fuel system problems that prevent the proper amount of fuel from entering the combustion chamber. It might be a bigger problem, like a leaky fuel injector or the fuel pressure regulator. Additionally, you shouldn't rule out the possibility of a defective fuel pressure dampener. Up until the engine is warmed up, everything may appear normal with these parts. The majority of the symptoms appear as soon as the fuel lines warm up. How to fix? You should begin looking for the issue as soon as you become aware of any performance issues. Look at the battery connections first after opening the hood. It makes sense to start here because this is one of the easiest problems to resolve. You can use your code scanner to identify the issue if the check engine light is turned on. Additionally, it doesn't hurt to try a fuel injection cleaner first if you suspect the fuel injectors may be clogged. This affordable substitute is much preferable to having to replace the injectors. Hope the information was useful for you. If so, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel.